Well, welcome to my studio. Today I'm working on a brand new commission. This is based on a painting that I had done previously, and we've made several changes to it. My collector loves to add birds and some of her pets, and so we've added some, well, the original piece that she saw had the cardinals, but we've decided to make the birdhouse purple with a shamrock on it because she has some Irish heritage in her family. And we've got the arbor is climbing roses. So I'm coming in, and these are mixtures of phthalo blue plus liquin and viridian green plus liquin. And that's given me a good dark for the foliage and all in the very back. And I'm going ahead and painting those leaves in right now. Then I'm going to come back and start doing some of my dark pinks in here. I'm going to go over that. I have to be very careful not to let that flower color get muddy. But I want it to drop back. I want it to stay dark. So this is a mixture of permanent rose plus magenta, and that gives me a nice dark pink. Some of the flowers underneath are going to be the darker, and the ones catching the light on top will be lighter. The light's coming in from the upper right. So I block these flowers in. Again, I have to clean my brush. See how that picked up some of that blue onto the brush? So I have to wipe that off to keep my flower color clean. I just wanted to get that dark established, and it's easy enough to clean my brush when I make this. Now I'm going to start coming back with my lighter pinks that are the flowers, the roses, and catching the light. And these, again, I will even highlight these lighter with some permanent rose plus white. This color I'm using now is permanent rose plus white, but I will add more white for flowers that will be in the highlights, for the highlights on the petals. I'll say it in a minute. My mouth is not cooperating. Sometimes I don't have real good brain-mouth coordination. Just bear with me. This piece is painted gallery wrap style over the sides of a gallery wrap canvas. But right now I'm not worried about painting that upper edge, because I have to get on a little stool to get up there to do that. So right now I'm just worried about getting my flowers blocked in here on the front. This again is permanent rose plus white. Now as we come back here, these are going to be more in shadow, so they'll be a little dark on this side. And then just this front edge will catch the light. But these back here will be darker. And then I'm going to have some nasturtiums coming up here in front of my flowers on the arbor. Now I'm bringing a little lighter pink into here. This is where my lighter roses will be. I'll come back and add more detail onto that later, but right now I just want to get some lights established. And this brush is called a bright brush. It's a square brush. I really like these because with the flat edge I can cover a large area, but then I can turn it and use the corner to make smaller brush strokes. See, even though that's a big brush, I'm making some fairly small brush strokes with that. This goes quickly. As you can see how my darks there are giving me a nice dark that then those light flowers are going to pop against. Now I'm coming back and I'm going to start painting the foliage around my flower color. You can see I can just work that around. Not as careful here. It doesn't matter if I get a little pink on that brush because the leaves can be a little more muted. But I want my flowers to be very bright. So I keep that brush really clean while I'm doing my flowers. Now this is a little phthalo blue plus white. And this adds coolness. I just add this here and there into the foliage. That helps bring some coolness into those leaves back there. Makes them drop back. Cool colors go back, warm colors come forward. This painting is based actually on our little kitchen garden. It's the garden that we see this little arbor out of our kitchen window. And I have a bird feeder there, and we have Mr. Chippers and Miss Chippers come and visit us, our cardinals. And we have blue jays and, oh, all kinds of different birds, wrens. We have a ladderback woodpecker that comes. And it's fun because I recognize all of their voices and their different calls, so I know who's there when I just hear their voices. It's really pleasant to be in the kitchen cooking. Not that I cook very much, but when I'm in the kitchen, I can usually, it's feeding the cats. I see the birds out there, and it's really a lot of fun. Jack used to love to sit at that window in the sun. He was on kidney dialysis and was taking blood thinners. And so he'd get very cold, and that window in the winter gets that south sun pouring in. So he used to sit there and just love to sit there and watch the birds. Very pleasant spot. That sun would pour in. Now Sissy's taken over that spot. She's my sun baby. She loves to just lay in that sun and enjoy. Now I'm going to have sunflowers in this pot here, but I'm going to let a few of these leaves just come back down in here. Got some hair in there. Probably cat hair. Wonder who that came from. Not that we don't have cats around here. That Molly and Sissy. And there's going to be flowers in this swan vase, so I'm not going down any further with that. Now I use lighter colors in here because that sun's going to be popping on those. And some of my cools. I just pop color up here. I can always come back and add highlights and this. Don't want to come too far over my iris. They're kind of back behind where this arch comes down. But I'm going to let them show. I don't want to cover over those. A few little leaves back up in here. These will be darker because they're in shadow. Now, what I'm going to do here is I have saved my background color. And I'm going to come in and work around these leaves, these flowers, and just fill in those little openings. I don't want those flowers to come down that far because I want to see the birdhouse and the Mrs. Chippers, female cardinal. So I can just take some of that background color that I've saved. And I'll even come in here and just add a few little openings into these leaves. Just that laciness gives the feeling of those leaves and things coming down. Pop a few little, well, I was going to pop some lights. I didn't get it. There we go. I just lay that color over the darker color. Just going to lay it so it doesn't, it stays light. A little here and there. Roses have a three come out with leaves that have three on them. So that's three, let's see, three leaves on them. I'll say it in a minute. But there we are. Our roses are blocked in. And I'll come back and add more detail to them, but that gives you the feel of how they're blocked in. I really appreciate you following along. Please visit my blog. The address is on the final frame of my YouTube video as well as in the description below. I also would love for you to subscribe to my YouTube channel. You'll receive an email every time I post a new YouTube video. Thank you so much for following along, and happy painting!